The tables have turned. Darian Waller shifted their focus to the surgically repaired left knee of Gallows to a great deal of success thus far, but Wade, Gallows not staying down.
Yeah, they built.
Oh my lord!
Well, Gallows not opting to go for the pin there. That could have finished things perhaps more in dire need.
And Meechin with an arm drag to Waller.
Lucky the referee didn't see that one. Santos Escobar, who has just found an extra gear so far this evening.
Escobar, the self-proclaimed emperor of Lucha Libre, would certainly solidify his claim by taking Mysterio out of action yet again, but Rey out of the way in time.
Santos Escobar had to commit to that move, but he simply overcommitted.
Oh, no.
Now he's in danger.
Mysterio! My God! From the top of the ring post, taking out Santos. Basically turning Rezar and Akam into, oh my goodness, trained killers here in WWE.
Scheming, plotting his way to success, but do not write off the Street Profits.
Don't discount the outrageous athleticism of Angelo Dawkins or Montez Ford. Montez Ford having all types of fun, but the fun stops now. Oh God, oh no.
Simply too powerful, my word.
Ford was just powerbombed into Dawkins.
Yeah!
You can't stop AOP. I don't care who you are.
And he may have to do this completely on his own, given the damage to Luke Gallows.
Theory wanted A-Town down. Anderson able to escape now from the second turnbuckle. Carl Anderson lining Theory up. Neckbreaker. Cover by Anderson. And Theory keeps it alive.
Carl Anderson just looks like he's moving on fast forward, simply a step ahead of everything Theory and Waller have tried. And this might be good night.
This might be the magic killer. Waller coming to the aid of his partner.
Keeping his team's hopes of qualifying for WrestleMania alive.
Theory from behind. Feet on the ropes. Theory and Waller steal it.
Ready to put the finishing touches to AOP.
This is a risky proposition. Akam able to free himself. This could be catastrophic for the Profits now.
Oh,
good Lord.
Cleaning the clock of Montez Ford. And it's that easy, despite that flurry from Angelo Dawkins. Just one boot, and AOP back on top. Good night.
The final chapter.
Oh.
Oh, and Angelo Dawkins keeps it alive.
Angelo Dawkins wants to get to WrestleMania. But is it in vain at this point?
Is Dawkins simply prolonging the inevitable?
I mean, the guy's a fighter, the guy's a winner, but how much do you have to throw at AOP to stop them for more than a beat?
I mean, AOP look like a couple of Terminators right now, just continuing to march forward, and Dawkins again, inside cradle by Ford, shoulders down. Montez did it! Oh my God! Official Jessica Carr reaching the count of eight. Rey getting Santos back inside of the squared circle.
All of that resentment over the past several months, finally, perhaps some of it.
Whoa, 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 whoa!
Rey Mysterio!
No, Wade, you know better.
That's Rey Mysterio who's in the ring!
You know exactly. You can't be serious.
He got us all.
619 from Escobar after the distraction by Dirty Dominic Mysterio. Phantom Driver hooks both legs. And Escobar steals the win.
Here's your winner, Santos Escobar.
Who is honking the horn?
I said on site. I said on site. Yeah! I tried to get
told you, you gotta show up. Cause I show up right here.
Well, that's where our cameras stopped rolling, but we were able to get the following footage from the local police department.
Police, stop, stop fighting! Police, get in the police, stop fighting, stop fighting! Stop fighting, get off him! Stop fighting! Put your hands behind your back, put your hands behind your back!
Naomi now. Oh, it's the Kabuki Warriors and Dakota Kai. Surprise, surprise. Damage control hits the scene. Io stomping over Naomi, perched on the top. Over the moonsault.
This is...
Wait a second. Bianca Belair has hit the scene and just dropped Dakota Kai.
Well, Belair had no interest in helping Bayley out, but Naomi is a very different proposition, and the EST is dropping anything that moves.
The EST laying waste to damage control. Kairi Sane has the blade of Belair.
It's been four versus one, and the one is winning.
The one is downright dominating. We are talking about the EST, whose life has been made hell by damage control.
It's the one woman equalizer, but Dakota Kai goes low, taking out the knee of the EST.
And even Belair now being overwhelmed by the numbers of damage control.
You all would be lucky to be a number two, but you're not even close. This is the greatest number two of all time. But that's all you will ever be, is number two. Because I'm number one. Forever.
I'm the greatest number two? The greatest number two. Well, when it comes to WrestleMania, when it comes to who defeats you for this championship that you've held for all this time, I'm not number two. I'm the one.
Here comes the enforcer.
The soulless eyes of Solo Sikoa and that gleeful grin of Jimmy Uso about to do what they have done for years here in WWE.
The sharks have begun to circle. To Cody's credit, he is still standing his ground mid-ring before the bloodline.
Cody's not a runner, and that might be his biggest fault. Just over 2 weeks ahead of the biggest weekend of his life at WrestleMania.
Wait, that's main event, Jay! That's Seth freaking Rollins!
Two can play at that game.
It seems like Cody Rhodes may have gotten the jump on Roman Reigns for once.
Cody Rhodes was not born yesterday.
The tables have turned.